Well, how are we doing, folks? Right, welcome to another video. We're at Watcliffe's Dover yet again. I've got something that I want to try out. I've got a couple of, I've got a scanner and I've got a digital radio. I'm in the docks, as you can see. And yeah, we're going to try it out. There's also someone here that you might know, folks. Someone you haven't seen in a long time.
Hello.
It's Debbie. Remember Debbie? We're getting married soon, folks.
Less than 3 months.
So, yeah. She's going to help film today because obviously I've got binoculars as well and all that stuff. So yeah. Let's carry on the journey. How are we doing, folks? Right.
Got binoculars.
Birthday present from Debbie. Thank you very much, love them. I want more powerful ones for the next birthday.
That was that anniversary.
Oh, was it anniversary again?
Yeah.
Oh, right. And this is a scanner. So this actually got this like over 10 years ago from a mate's dad, who's a radio enthusiast. And I never really used it. And I found it the other day in a filing cabinet. And I thought, I'll give that a go. Because I started getting into CB and stuff like that. I put a community post out the other day. To see if anyone in the Dover area had a CB. But no, I couldn't get in contact with anyone. Unfortunately, the area was not that great at the moment. Need to get it on the old, on the roof, folks. But let's see what we can pick up. And I've got this one as well. This is a digital radio. This is not a scanner that we can pick. If we got the frequencies, we can pick up, like at the moment, the frequency of the Dover port. So we can pick up what they're saying. Port control. So if anyone wants to come in and out of the port, they have to communicate on this. So let's see if we can pick it up. I've got one bar left on this, so that's. And this is really old, you know, we're talking like, must be early 90s. That's a port.
Oh, got people.
Right, then, thanks. So I'm going to put this one away, keep it on out for now, and we'll get back to that later. A bit more to see here than the hills. Yeah, it's really clear, isn't it? I mean, those binoculars are really powerful. They really do get in close. You have to get, you know, get a attachment for the old camera, folks.
Someone eating their dinner over there.
Is there? Right then, folks. So we're looking, scanning. I forget the bands. I'm just scanning random at the moment. This is just a scanner, an old-fashioned scanner. It takes, what was it? It takes 6 AA batteries in the back there. Yeah, never really play with it. I mean, I've picked some bits up. It does work for its age. Check it out on Google, folks. And yeah, I'm just playing with that at the moment. What's that DFDS there? I mean, the fumes come out of that. It's not black, it's like, what do we say, vodka, diluted with water, so we can get that weird, it looks like a petrol, I suppose, sort of a weird texture. That's coming out of funnels. I want to talk about global warming, folks. That's coming down the Dover. Get some binoculars and see it with your own eyes. You can't see it with the naked eyes, really, can you? I think you can. Really? Binoculars? Yeah, picks up digital signals as well as. There you go. That's analog, but. It's picking up that building there, I believe, that brown one. Over port control. Quite interesting listening, actually. Need to get some more frequencies to whack in that at some point. But yeah, best place to come, folks. More boat soup there. It's quiet.
Minute 25 for the bridge. Okay, thanks, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Sequel?
You can listen to the communication between the little boats and the control, and you can see the boats coming in and waiting in the marina.
Yeah, okay, off the jet, wait to come into the jet pool terminal. For your information, I do have a survey vessel heading that way into the jet pool terminal to do
it's
survey.
The same jet pool.
Okay, I'll come in.
You said jet terminal.
Right, should we make a wander?
Yeah.
Towards Margaret's Bay. That over there, didn't even know this, folks, I don't know if you knew about this. The P&O Pioneer is a new P&O ferry, I do believe. I've never seen one like that before. It's got these weird windows at the side, like a bay window at the side. This ferry here, right there. You can't really see it, but there you go. Well, it's a hot day today, isn't it?
Sorry?
Hot day today.
Yeah. Raining like constantly for ages, and now we've got a week off and it's like summer again.
Yeah. Yep, a bit too hot for my liking, you know. I don't like it this hot. It was foggy. Right, let's go.
No hotter than this, like this is perfect.
Yeah, what's the temperature, do you reckon? 20?
I think it's only about 21.
Is it really?
Yeah.
That's a bit mental. I've got a red head from the other day. Christ. Working on the IKS van. Right, so this little boat here.
Yeah, we've just pulled back on our time a little bit. I'll give you a try as soon as
you're ready, sir. Waiting for the ferry. They've been told to wait there at the yellow boy.
Darling, over there.
For the ferry to go through. Can't really see it, folks, but.
Darling, BTS, okay. Ferry entry to Spirit of Britain. If you'd like to follow the Spirit of Britain in, please, the eastern entrance once inside.
There you go, folks. He's going to go in, follow the boat in. This is certainly a different take on the old videos, isn't it, folks? Eh? Now we're talking ferries and yachts and marinas. Indeed. Oh, I can't transmit on these radios. I need a license and a code, a special code to go in, but I haven't got that. But yeah, there he goes, he's off. How amazing is that, folks? Alright, let's move on. I don't remember doing a video on this, but you got these cutouts in the chalk, and you go into these cutouts and it reflects the sound coming over the channel. Let's go and take a look. This. Sit back, got a load of rubbish here that someone's dumped. Dirty buggers, aren't they? And it reflects the sound. So you can hear planes in that. So this might be pre Second World War, you know, we're talking.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there you go.
Interesting.
Interesting, yeah. Didn't expect the rubbish to be in there, folks. Right then, folks, so got this band going. This is, I think this is aircraft. There's a helicopter. Don't know. This is scanning the frequencies at the moment. Who knows? Still talking BTS? VTS? Nothing, is there?
No.
And you can follow this yacht, the Darling, into the PD.
Damn.
Missed it.
Missed it, folks. Should really get the frequencies. Certainly lovely for marine radio, folks, up on the White Cliffs of Dover. I can pick it up at home, can't we? So
yeah.
It's not too bad. Okay, moving on. Just watching a kestrel, folks, looking for a meese. You got him?
I can't see it.
He's gone. There he goes. Oh! Is that the wind? The wind took him, folks. There he is, down in the grass. You see him?
Whoa.
There he goes. The old claws come out then as well. Holy Jesus. I must admit, folks, these shoes have seen better days. But, and don't say it. That's blue, that's black. Fair enough.
That's my fault, because I can't
pair. No, it's been like that for a while, because... It's been like that for a long time, because I can never find the right ones. And these are decent ones. Calvin Klein socks. And, you know, there's only one of each colour. And also the shoes, folks, have seen better days. I only found that out earlier. They were bought in 2000 and... Do you remember? No, these were bought in 2000 and... It's either 13 or 14.
What?
Yeah.
That
I've done a couple of marathons in these. Half marathons, should I say. Half marathons. Just for fun, I do it some... Well, don't do it as much anymore, folks. Getting old now. Nearly 40. So, yeah. They're going in the bin. These are their last journey, sadly. And I can't find them on eBay. If you can find them on eBay for us, folks, check it in the comment section. In UK, so yeah, cheers. Right then, folks, we're at Fan Bay, probably between Dover and St Margaret's, a bit further over towards St Margaret's. And Fan Bay, they've been doing a lot of work. They've done the deep shelter, they dug all that out, the National Trust, and found out that they dug out the one of the gun positions. They're doing two of them, aren't they? Is that what you said?
I think so.
Two gun positions.
It's one fucking exposed.
Yeah. Look at that, that's shit up here. That's the magazine, isn't it? You've been in, did you go in there?
I've not, I don't.
Isn't that mad? And you can see the magazine in the back there, look. They've done a good job there. Real good job. That guy drove past in a like a VW camper. I thought it was a tourist at first, and then he had like a portable engine on the back of it. I thought, oh no, here we are. Look at that. Look, it's got the bearing around the edges. Right in. Isn't that amazing?
Oh, that door's sealed up, isn't it?
Yeah, the magazine. Isn't that good? What have they done, folks? Never ever thought, I thought this was all demolished.
Yeah.
Blown up.
It's all there under our feet.
Yeah. Little control room there, maybe.
Little bricks and that. Oh, that's another
one. Yeah, that's what I said, the bearings around the.
Nice.
Which way the gun's facing. That's mad, isn't it? We can smell them sleepers. This will be open to the public soon, won't it? You've done a good job out here, folks. Very good job, the old National Trust. Indeed. I think that magazine was the best preserved one because the unfortunately the graffiti artist got in there and started spray painting them. Well, they're not artists, are they?
Vandals.
Graffiti vandals. And that's the deep shelter entrance down there. That's where you get your tours from, folks. Tunnel tours. You've never been in that one, have you?
No.
Should take a tour, really. And there it is. I don't know when they open. used to go in that shelter when it was just a hole in the ground. That's mad, isn't it?
How many years ago was that?
2004.
What, you and Colin?
Yeah, me and Colin used to go in there. That was literally a hole in the ground, that's mad. Alright then, onwards.
Oh, it's padlocked.
That was it?
Yeah.
Damn.
It will be open though, won't it?
Yeah. Public, so. Little cafe up there. I don't understand why they don't have micro pubs or bars. They could get them involved. It'd be a great outing.
Oh, that'd be amazing.
People spend all day out here then, drinking. Money. Yeah, even if they were a bit more expensive than normal, even better. Kissing gate indeed, folks.
Fan Hole.
Fan Hole, that's behind us, like Langdon Hole.
25th of September 1941.
1941. That's inside the shelter, look. This is the plan of it. So this is where you see, this is the entrance just in front of us here. And it goes downstairs into the main complex. And these are the entrances that are come out in the cliff down near the sound mirrors.
Oh yeah.
How mad is that? Emergency hospital, emergency store. That's a good plan. I've never seen, you know.
1941 plans.
That's when it was made though, when the construction. So the original plans, folks. This is like an artist's impression of how it used to look. Bunk beds. Basically accommodation shelters, aren't they? Deep protection. We're talking, what, 50 feet underground? 60. Constructed in 1940 to 1941. There you go, folks. So check out the website below, folks, because we're going to have some a link down there so you can have a look. And maybe if you're in the Dover area, like all these tourists, they probably know nothing about it. Book a tour. We definitely will at some point.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah.
To the pub.
Stop.
Right then, folks. So, South Fallen Lighthouse near the Gun Battery, South Fallen Battery. There's another lighthouse called North Fallen Lighthouse, which is in Thanet. Right then, folks. So we made it to South Fallen. Obviously, the Gun Battery is back up that way, but we're walking down to, what's it called? St Margaret's Bay.
Yeah.
Got a lovely little pub right on the bay. But looking at the weather, looking at the amount of people out, we're not going to get a seat.
Oh, I hope we do. That's why we're half running to get there, because there's other tourists that I think are going to the same
place.
Yeah, still
people behind. To keep like running to sort of get, they try and overtake.
Get ahead of them.
Yeah. But we'll soon find out. Need a wee as well. Don't help. Long walks. Yeah, it could go in the bush, folks, but it's not very good for nature, is it? So, see you in a bit. Right, the other folks, so we made it to the, what's it called?
Coast Guard. Yeah.
Got a lager. And a lovely, lovely view. That's it. And we got a burger coming. Got the is it really? Spit, this is a Spitfire Lager. New one. And you just got a Coca-Cola.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lovely job, folks. So yeah, we got a burger and onion rings, classic burger. Got it before, didn't we? But lovely. Cheers. Well, here we go then, folks. Onion rings, burger, chips. I think things are looking pretty good. Right then, folks, so we finally made it to St Margaret's Bay. Had something to eat, lovely burger, onion rings and all that jazz. Had the lager. And now it's basically have a sit down here, listen to the radio. And we got an ice cream, folks. Mine come in a little tub because it started falling apart. Yours isn't leaking.
It's literally going all over my hands.
That lovely ice cream though, isn't it? Right, yeah, so St Margaret's Bay, folks. It's interesting how it used to look during the Second World War. There's a video I'm going to put in the description. Check it out. And it shows you what it looked like. I think it was bombed or something like that. Something happened here. Can't remember off the top of my head. But check that link out in the description. It'll show you like this video clip. And it's quite interesting. What do you reckon, War Department, folks? I said this is a War Department sign. What do you reckon?
Oh yeah, it is, isn't it?
It's got to be.
CPO or GPO?
GPO. Ah. Yeah, so Second World War, War Department, I guess. GPO lines.
We've got one of those signs under our stairs, don't we?
Yeah.
Under the shelf.
On the wood.
Yeah.
Yeah, folks. Yeah, I like those little cheap War Department signs. They're very distinctive. You see them everywhere. Right, we're making a journey home, folks. It's been a good day. Hope you enjoyed that video. It's not finished yet. We'll see what else we can find for you. But, hey, lots of posh houses around here. Look how lovely this looks, folks. Hey? I don't know if you know it comes out. It probably doesn't come out as well.
It looks like a secret garden.
Doesn't it? Right, so we turned off to the right and yeah, mysterious little route. Never took this route before. This is like South Foreland. This is like the bits near the battery of South Foreland Battery. So I thought we'd have a little journey down here. Public footpath, Kent County Council. Do you hear that? Silence. Yeah. But, you know, no people, no tourists. Hello! Nature, at its best, folks.
Quiet.
Yeah, this is where you see a Nuke's top five. You see someone in the bush and you don't realise it.
Yeah.
Look how old that is, a fence post. Oldie. It's like razor, they would have had like wire on it and stuff. That might be Second World War from the battery.
What about this stone? Is that oldie?
Oh, that looks old. We're finding some gems here, folks, aren't we? SV. So we're at a crossroads. That's a road to someone's car down there, folks. Another fence here. Same one. Right. Yeah. So should we go up this way? That's the way we need to go.
Yeah, wherever.
Let's go.
I thought you were giving me a thumbs up.
Thumbs up, folks, let's go. Cattle grids, gotta love them. How was that?
That was pretty good.
Pretty good.
I can't do it, I can't do it.
I can't do it, I can't do it. I'll fall through it. Look at this though. Never ever been down here. The amount of times come out here. It's like, wow. It's like South Foreland Battery. This is like pre that, you know.
Wow.
South Foreland Battery's further up that way. But this is obviously what it would have been like before the battery was positioned. Now there's still concrete remains up there, you know, loads of it, underground remains. I want to check those videos out, folks. Check the old description. There'll be a series of videos of what remains at South Foreland Battery. Madness.
So we were originally on that hill, weren't we?
Yeah. Don't know how far up was we up there?
Sure.
Was it further up? Don't think it's high.
This way, that path goes up. That first level. See what I mean?
Yeah.
I think it was just there.
Mad.
Lovely, isn't it? Peaceful, isn't it?
Beautiful. Right then, folks, we'll see you soon. Right then, folks, so we thought to stop off here. We're on the way home now, as you know. But this, for many years, plotting room between Dover and St Margaret's called Fan Bay. We heard about it, but we always thought it was a rumour. But many, many years later, over a decade and a half later, or what have you, they decided to dig it out, National Trust. And here it is, Fan Bay plotting room, plotting the gun positions for the. Yeah. You come in? Yeah. This is the emergency exit bit. So you can see the farmer's field is all the way around. And yeah. Look how deep that is. Hello? Yeah. Had a plate over it. Yeah, so that's the emergency exit.
That is.
No, here. Oh. That lifts up. Would have been counterweights and ventilation pipes. And the main entrance is around the other side.
Oh,
okay. So, yeah, we've been in here, folks. We've got permission by the National Trust to obviously look after this site. Want to see the video? Check the description out. Video's there, folks, for you to see. I'll show you the main entrance around the corner. Original road for the plotting room. It's a sliding hatch. So this is the main way down. Capped ventilation pipes, intakes maybe. And that slid, massive drop in there, would have had ladders or what have you. But
call me back at the entrance to the outer marina.
Right, yeah, then, folks. So we're back at the hull, Langdon Hull. Just watching the boats here. What's going on here? So a little boat there is going in. He needs to get permission. I don't know if he's had it yet. He's going to the Yellow Boy. There's a P&O ferry's coming in. What is it? It's the P&O Pioneer again. Oh, blimey. Was it when we went to St Margaret's, it was that one.
It was going out, wasn't it?
Yeah. He's going towards it, it seems. Experimental. Who are they down there? There's the marina. There you are, Irish Ferries, folks. Can't get much clearer than that, surely. So that's what I can see.
Good afternoon, 5 minutes now with 564.
It's obviously much clearer like this.
Five Canterbury on 5564, thank you.
In, yeah, what did you say, Inshear?
Inshear.
Look.
Yeah.
Irish Ferries. Are they manned? By Irish people.
Definitely.
Or are they like, you know. Oh, no, we have been on Irish ferries actually. We went over there, we went to Calais, Dunkirk and all that. And, you know, we went over on Irish ferries and that weren't too bad. Weren't too bad. Don't think the video's out yet, folks, but, yeah, weren't too bad at all. Good day today, eh?
Yeah.
How are we doing, folks? Right, so yeah, we're back at Langdon, past Langdon Hole now, Langdon car park and all that sound. Look at this up here, there's a robot. That's the Coast Guard station up there, radar and all that jazz. And this thing here looks like a robot. Now, I'll zoom in a bit so you can see it a little bit better. I reckon that's something to do with catching the migrants coming across the channel. That might be thermal imaging camera, you know, night vision. Yeah, it's not been there before. That's a new addition. I haven't seen that before. It looks like a robot. Mandus, folks. Yeah. Radar up there. Langdon Coast Guard. They've got dishes on the front there. They've got skin over it. The skin is split, exposing the radar equipment underneath. on that radar equipment now is exposed to the elements of the weather. There's something over here I forgot to look at. Saw this last time. I don't know if I've ever filmed this before. Look at this. It's like a little gun position. That's like hidden away. Do we ever find out what this was? No, I don't know. I mean, this has got to be, this is, you know, late 1800s, early 1900s, same era as the battery, Langdon battery up there with the Coast Guard's on. So, yeah, it's weird. Might be small gun position or observation. Who knows, folks? Langdon Cliffs, full of mystery, full of intrigue. Let's continue going up. Came to the end of the journey, folks. So yeah, thanks very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. Something different, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Check out Instagram, Facebook, and all that jazz. Thanks very much for the support, patron, and membership, and all that. Some new videos coming out soon. And yeah, we'll see you soon, folks. Take it easy.